nothing else to say. We just say, yes, we receive. And yes, we believe. There's nothing else to say. It's already done. We're going to give those of you an opportunity who believe our report and to whom the arm of the Lord has been revealed to come and accept the Lord as your Savior. We're going to do what we're going to do quickly. We don't want you to leave because we're going to show our love, not in words, but in deed and in truth. We're giving you an opportunity to come now and accept the Lord as your Savior. We're giving you an opportunity now to come and join this church and be taught how to follow after that for which he apprehended you. He apprehended us to be called of God in Christ Jesus. The Spirit says, come. If you will come now, softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he's waiting and watching. Watching for you and for me. Come home, come home, ye who are weary, come home, earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling, oh sinner, come home. Why would you tarry when Jesus is pleading? He's pleading for you and for me. Why would you linger and heed not his mercy? His mercy for you and for me. Come home, come home. Weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling.
Calling for sinner, I'm only temporarily interrupting Mother Deola because of something that I said this morning, and I felt I needed to repeat it. Recognizing that we are living at a time in our nation when the Lord is doing what he said in Revelation, when he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. When 9/11/2001 occurred, it was God knocking upon the door, the harbor of New York. few days ago, he knocked on the harbor of New Orleans. Yesterday, he knocked on the harbor of Galveston. What is the harbor? It's a port. Whether it be a seaport or an airport, it is a legal entrance into a country. Don't get confused and think that knocking on the port of New York means that he's trying to get New York's attention. That's where all of the great commerce of our nation, the refineries are down on the Gulf Shore. He's not knocking at the door of these cities, he's knocking at the door of this nation. He's telling us, let me in. And I said to the saints this morning that although the day after Katrina struck and Sister Sherby Grubbs was so quick to pull together between 10:30 that morning and 1 o'clock that afternoon food to feed about 200 people who had fled from New Orleans and from southern Alabama and Mississippi. And that Tuesday night was church anyway, and we raised a little over $8,000, increased that to 10, split it between 4 pastors and that congregation. We had our Thursday night celebration of our founder, Bishop Mason, Thursday night before last. And we raised a certain amount of money for Kojic Charities, and I gave from myself and my wife $60,000 in that offering. But the Lord spoke to my heart, and I said to the saints this morning, and I mentioned Brother and Sister Covington, that they will be my lead persons on this. But he put it in my spirit that personally, Sister Patterson and I, we want to move, relocate a family. I don't know whether it's coming out of the first or the second hurricane to Memphis. I believe that we'll be able to get the church and we'll do a second. But whether it's the pastor and church together or the church doing one and the family doing one, we intend to, I don't know, is the word repatriate? I don't know. I may have the wrong word. But we want to move at least 2 families who have lost everything. In order to make sure that we don't get involved with some shrewd ripoff artist, then naturally there are some procedures they're going to go through to search it out. But this is that day when the Lord says, whosoever hath this world's goods, seeth his brother hath need, and shut up his bowels of compassion from him, how dwelleth the love of God in him? I wish you'd tell somebody, you are not blessed just to be blessed. But like Abraham, God bless you to make you a blessing.
Let's praise God for our leader. Praise God for our pastor.